This photograph is a dissection, and on this photo, I wanted to point out the space where the retrocalcaneal bursa would be located. I'm holding the Achilles tendon in my right hand, and Kager's fat pad has been removed. You might be able to see a little bit of fat remaining, but I want you to notice that the Achilles tendon isn't attached to the most superior part of the calcaneus. It's attached probably, I'd say, to the inferior or distal two-thirds of it, and that proximal or superior third is where the retrocalcaneal bursa is located. This photo shows how, well, first let me start by saying that the talus has been removed. You can see the posterior calcaneal facet, and then you can see the middle and the anterior facet for the talus. And you can notice on this specimen that those two facets are joined as one facet. Notice also where the interosseous tail of calcaneal is pointed out in the calcaneal sulcus. This photograph demonstrates a specimen that had a calcaneo-navicular coalition that I mentioned in the video when we were looking at just the calcaneus. But you can see that the anterior and middle talar facets for the calcaneus are one oval facet, and then you can see the navicular, the concave surface for the talus. Notice how it's C-shaped, and then there was a bony bridge between the calcaneus and the navicular, so that's a calcaneo-navicular coalition.